We came to honor you alone, O God. We thank you for who you are, O God. We thank you for this day, Lord. We worship you, O God. You are worthy.
Thank you, Jesus.
You are adorable, God. You're the King of Kings.
Thank you, Jesus.
We came to honor you alone, O God.
Thank you, Jesus.
There is none like you, my dear Master.
Thank you, Jesus.
Receive our worship, O Lord.
Thank
Receive
you,
our
Jesus.
Adoration, O God.
Thank you,
we
Jesus.
We exalt you, O God.
Oh, yes.
You are highly lifted up, O God.
Hallelujah.
Father, we thank you. We honor you, O God.
We honor you, Lord.
We give you glory, Lord. As we honor you, we give you glory, Lord. As we honor you, you are wonderful. You are worthy, oh Lord. You
Your presence. We ask, oh God, that today, Jesus' name we pray. Give the Lord a shout of praise. Hallelujah, somebody.
Amen.
I want us to remain standing. We are going to go into prayers tonight. But like I normally tell us, we normally pray through the scripture, isn't it?
Yes.
I want us to look at the book of Deuteronomy chapter 1. I'd like us to see from verse 6 to 8. Deuteronomy chapter number 1. And we are going to look at verses 8. Verses 6 to 8. Are you there? If you are there, say amen. Quickly open it. Deuteronomy. Good evening, viewers. God bless you. We are on already from Solid Foundation Christian Center Worship Center. And we also enjoin you to open your Bible with us to Deuteronomy chapter 1. We are reading verse 6 to 8. Deuteronomy 1 from verse 6 to 8. I read from the Old King James Version. The Word of God says, the Lord our God spake unto us in Horeb, saying, ye have dwelt long enough in this mountain. I want you to take note of that. The Lord our God spake unto us in Horeb, saying, ye have dwelt long enough in this mountain. Talking about stagnation. This was almost 38 years of wandering in the wilderness after they left where? After they left Egypt. Praise the name of the Lord.
Yeah.
This was after 38 years. Huh? Hallelujah.
Yeah.
You see? Turn you and take your journey and go to the mount of the Amorites and to all the places nigh there unto, in the plain, in the hills, and in the valley, and in the south, and by the seaside, to the land of the Canaanites, and unto Lebanon, unto the great river, the river Euphrates. Behold, I have set the land before you. Behold, I have done what? I have set the land before you. Go in and possess the land which the Lord swear unto your fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, to give unto them and to their seed after them. The Lord is saying tonight, the land is set before you. Though you have been stagnated before now, the power of God is moving you into that land of promise. In the name of Jesus, the chains of stagnation shall be broken over your destiny. In the name of Jesus. Joel chapter 2. If you are finding it difficult, just listen to me. Joel chapter 2, from verse 25 to 28 to 27. Hallelujah, somebody.
Praise God.
The word says, and I will restore to you. And I will restore to you the years that the locusts are eating, the canker worm,
yes,
and the caterpillar,
uh-huh,
and the palmer worm,
yes,
my great army which I sent among you. And ye shall eat in plenty,
yes,
and be satisfied,
yes,
and praise the name of the Lord your God,
yes,
that hath dealt wondrously with you.
Amen.
And my people shall never be ashamed.
Yes.
And ye shall know that I am the Lord in your midst. And that I am the Lord your God,
yes,
and none else,
yes,
and my people shall never be ashamed.
Yes.
Emphasis, my people shall never be ashamed. The year of the canker worm is the year of stagnation.
Yes.
The year of the canker worm is the wasted years.
Yes.
The year of the power hammer worm is the year of fruitless labor. The Lord is saying today, I shall restore you.
I am being restored.
I am being restored. Isaiah 60, 1 and 2. Isaiah chapter 60, from verse 1 to 2. The word says, arise, shine, for the light is come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon thee.
Yes.
For behold, the darkness shall cover the earth, and gross darkness the people. For the Lord shall rise upon thee, and his glory shall be seen upon thee. Say, I am rising, and I will shine, for my light has come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon me. Say a proper amen. Say a proper amen. Say a proper amen. This is the focus of our prayer tonight. When you are supposed to shine, and you walk in darkness, that darkness represents stagnation. And what is stagnation? Stagnation is the inability to move into the next level because you cannot even perceive that level. Hallelujah, somebody. It's not that you are delayed. It's not that you are confused. Hallelujah. You are making effort, but your effort is merry-go-round. You go from circle to circle. You go from pillar to post. You are stagnated because you don't know the next thing to do. Because there are powers that have made it impossible for you to get an insight into the next level of your destiny. But tonight the Lord is saying, arise and shine, for there is a grace to your stagnation. In the name of Jesus, lift up your right hand. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I plead the blood. Demon. Everything begins to go out. The arrow that makes can't tell what to do with the money. The Bible that makes you to have a house of your own, but you don't have the courage to go back home at night because peace has eluded you. The Bible that makes you to have education, but everywhere you go, you cannot get employment. People that are less qualified are doing better than you do. That is the arrow of stagnation. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, every arrow of stagnation.
Show us your skill.
Every arrow of poverty that have taken covenant with your lifestyle, that have said you will not prosper, tonight by the power of the anointing, I set them on fire. I bring their yoke over you. If you can say amen, say amen.
Amen.
Esau, his destiny was stolen. But he was not lacking material things. Hallelujah. But his purpose was defeated in his own eyes. When Jacob came back, he brought him gifts and he did receive it. He said to Jacob, all this I have. Hallelujah. Esau was denied the opportunity to be a patriarch. He was denied the opportunity to be one of the pillars upon which the plan and purpose of God for the world will stand.
Yes,
he had cattle. He had animals. He had gold. But he was a man with a field purpose. Lift up your right hand. Say, Father, every arrow of stagnation, fighting my purpose, fighting my vision, fighting my dreams, fighting my marriage, fighting my finances, fighting my health. Today, I command the earth to open up and swallow them. Let your hands and carry them. In the name of Jesus. Let Papa Shakaya. Let me go to the Lord. Let Papa Yaha. Every arrow of stagnation. My Shakaya.
Thank you.
Whatever is stagnant becomes stale. Whatever is stagnant begins to rot. Whatever is stagnant begins to deteriorate. Whatever is stagnant begins to smell. Whatever is stagnant begins to become dirt. Hallelujah. Whatever is stagnant is not attractive. Hallelujah. The woman with the issue of God is an example of stagnation. She ate. The Bible says for 12 years. She had only one son. The issue of blood. All she sought was solution. And that situation of stagnation rendered her poor. Because the Bible says she spent all that she had. And she became an eyesore to the society. Are you angry that some people have decided to turn their back on you? Don't be mad at them. When your light shines tonight and your glory rises, they will come to your life. Hallelujah, somebody.
Amen.
Say, Father, every demonic entity that is at work in my destiny to stagnate me, enough is enough. Tonight I refuse.
Thank you.
show you another dimension of salvation. Your mother never lived in her old age with your father. She either died or separated. She might still be living. You might be married, but you and your husband are just like tenants. Eh? What stagnated your mom is already having its way in your life. Stagnation that is synonymous. And you and your mom, you are telling yourself, men are all evil. It has nothing to do with men. Hey, are those women who are your friends who are happily married? Do they have several heads?
I refuse.
Your father was a driver in the company where you are working now. And now you are an office assistant. And they know you as a generation of workers. But none of you has ever directed the company. Scalination. It's possible you have a 52-inch TV in the house. It does not mean prosperity. Because your TV produces nothing, it takes from you.
Yes.
Hallelujah. It's even possible you are riding a car. Hallelujah. It does not mean you are not calculated. Because the day you begin to fulfill purpose and begin to enhance destiny, that is when you are totally free from the yoke of stagnation. Hallelujah. There was a small boy during COVID-19, somewhere in the Nyanza region, I think, or Western. His first radio station is built when he was in class 4. And this time around, he has built another one. He has 400 listeners. He built his radio station from an abandoned water house in their neighborhood. Now, citizens or NTP, one of them saw him. Why? Because his light is shining. The yoke of stagnation broke. The boy will be snapped up. He will be sponsored. Hallelujah. And you are speaking in tongues. You are in one place. You and your mom, you are possibly your husband or possibly your wife. You see, that is how women are. If you don't handle them with my brain, this is the yoke of stagnation. Break it tonight. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The same pattern that your mom followed while she went to the grave is already showing forth in your own life. And then you are smiling. It is the demon of stagnation. So you are going to pray that prayer again. All those demons of stagnation that have become synonymous with you, those evil that you have become so familiar with, today you are breaking free from them.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus. Say, Father.
Father.
Hey, say, Father.
Father.
In the name of Jesus.
Symptoms, systems
of stagnation that has become synonymous with my lifestyle. Every element of stagnation in my imagination, in my conduct, in my speech, every element of stagnation that has become synonymous with my lifestyle. Today, what are you waiting for? I pray this from you. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray. They were free. Though they left the land of strength, but the system of slavery never left them.
Uh-huh.
Hallelujah. Yeah. Is somebody listening to me tonight?
Yes.
Though they left Egypt, but Egypt never left them. I always slight discomfort. Even though they're on the journey to a better place, they still crave for Egypt.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
The first moment they left, they go to a place called the Red Sea. Behind the Red Sea is the pathway to the promised land. Behind them is the land of slavery they have left. In between them and the land of slavery is the army of Pharaoh and their chariots.
Yes.
Now they are laughing.
Mm-hmm.
On their right,
yeah.
Hills, mountains.
Mm-hmm.
On their left, they are valleys.
Yes.
They are not squirrels. They cannot climb the mountains.
Yeah.
They are not fishes. They cannot swim in the Red Sea.
Yeah.
And they are not warriors. They cannot face Egypt.
Yeah.
So where did they go from there? They were stagnating.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
But the God of miracle,
yeah,
showed up in their midst of that. Hallelujah, somebody.
Amen.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
So these things are serious. Hallelujah. So that is that spirit of Kadesh Barnea that makes you to be 19 every year, that makes you to be 21 every year, that makes a 50-year-old man say he's 32. Hallelujah. And your granddaughter is calling you baby and saying, yes, dear, your brain needs checkup. Somebody who is old enough to be your granddaughter calls you that baby. I say, yes, darling. And then he pulls your, what is this? Your mustache. And you feel like a goat indeed. You are stagnated because there is no wisdom. I thought they said the degree here is the glory of the elders.
Amen.
How many of you want to feel, be free tonight? It's enough of roaming around. Enough of going from pillar to post.
Enough of going pillar to post.
I want to break through and I want to break through indeed.
I want to break through and break through indeed.
See, every spirit of Kadesh Barnea.
Every spirit of Kadesh Barnea.
I break your yoke.
There are brooms there.
you take brooms, you begin to sweep the forest. Because you are not supposed to enter that place without the permission of the owner. There are powers that are on your life, and though you don't belong to them. Tonight, their chains are broken over you. In the name of Jesus. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus.
My destiny arise and shine.
seeing what I am. Hallelujah, somebody. Your problem is, for the Lord is on the throne. That is your problem. Whatever you like, put there. But just see. Okay. I am going forward. Come on.
I am going forward.
I'm going for
There's this song that came to my mind. And whenever that song comes, there is a chord of blessing that have been struck in the realm of the spirit. Imela, Imela, Jehovah Imela. Imela, Imela, Jehovah Imela. Imela, Imela, Jehovah Imela. Amen. God will put a song in your mouth. And every ear that we hear will sing with you. It shall be a song of rejoicing. It shall be a joy of deliverance. It shall be a song of victory. It shall be a song of victory. It shall be a song of breakthrough. It shall be a song of your celebration. It shall be a song of your rising. In the name of Jesus. Say with me, no more stagnation. I pray for into glory. No more stagnation. My hands are lifted like that of the hurricane. I walk upon my high places. My life has come. I am shining. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. Put your hands down and give your glory. Hallelujah. We have come to the end of the meeting tonight. By the grace of God, tomorrow is going to be an anointing service. Tomorrow, we are going to be releasing the grace for accelerated progress. It has started tonight. Grace for accelerated financial breakthrough. Grace for open doors that people will wonder, how did you manage? Hallelujah. Yes. That is what we are going to be focusing on tomorrow as we fast and as we pray. We have used yesterday and today to clear the ground. As tomorrow comes, we shall celebrate our victory. Come with your anointing oil. Those of you who are at home, you carry your anointing oil with you while the service is going on. When I'm going to anoint the people of God, I will tell you how you are going to apply yours. And the victory that God has won for you tonight shall be permanent in your life.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
God bless you. Shall we say the grace? May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. God bless you, viewers. See you tomorrow by the grace of the living God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.